Hello, and welcome to our series, What is Brewing with ONTAP? My name is Eduardo Rivera, and I'm here to talk to you about ONTAP. First, let me give you a little background on myself. I've been working in big IT enterprise organizations for the better part of the last 20 years. And during that time, I think I spent the last 15 years working with storage, and specifically working with ONTAP. Fun fact is that all the ONTAP releases, I don't know if you know this, but all the ONTAP releases are all named after some beer. So every major ONTAP release has a code name internally of a beer. And as you can see here, I'm not having a beer today. I'm having some water, but we used to give out these glasses, right, that commemorate the different beers that represent our releases. But in any case, so why do we care? Why do I like ONTAP? Why do I want to talk to you about it? Aside from the fact that I work on NetApp, the reality is that ONTAP has served as the bedrock of all the data management that I have done for the better part of 15 years. There's other pros that we have used, of course, and whatnot, but ONTAP has had the strength, right, to really cater not only to the traditional workloads that we think about, right, being able to be a solid platform for databases or servers or all these physical things that sit on the data center that I'll call more traditional infrastructure components. But as we evolve over time, while we're still catering in terms of efficiency and data protection and security around the traditional workloads, we're now serving the workloads that are also more modern, things like Kubernetes, right, and cloud-based infrastructure that, again, needs data management. Which also brings me to the point that while at one point we were talking about many years ago about moving from physical servers to virtual servers, today we're even talking about virtual data centers, right, and the fact that there's this term called a hybrid cloud. And I think that the hybrid cloud gets a different definition depending on who you ask. But I'll say that the way I look at it is this, right? A hybrid cloud to me is a enterprise organization that has a need for resources, and it has a small or large physical presence that they manage, right? Perhaps a data center, a co-location with servers and whatnot. But at the same time, is leveraging some cloud resources, whether that is in AWS or Azure or GCP. You have compute, you have storage, and essentially you have almost like a multi data center approach. One is virtual, one is physical, and you own it. And the hybrid cloud is the ability to leverage those two pools of resources in a way that delivers not only the best that the compute and the tools that each offers, but also minimizing costs. And when it comes to the storage part of that, storage is always the heavy part, right? It's easy to spin up a server. It's hard to move the storage back and forth and that kind of stuff, right? So ONTAP today for us bridges a lot of that gap, right? So we have ONTAP on premises, we have ONTAP in the form of things like cloud volumes ONTAP or CVO, cloud volume service or CVS, and there's other technologies in there that allows us to have data in both places, move data back and forth, and then integrate the functionality of ONTAP, whether it's on premises or in the cloud, with modern platforms, like I mentioned earlier, like Kubernetes, right? We do that with technologies like Trident. So over the years, for us, it's been quite successful, right? And we've been, I'll say, continue to be very successful managing our data infrastructure through ONTAP. Well, thank you for watching the video today. I hope this was helpful to you. Hopefully it was informative. And stay tuned for episode 2, where I'm going to deep dive a little bit into those core ONTAP strengths. And we'll talk about how they have helped my team and my previous organizations manage storage, and how they also help today in reining in that hybrid cloud environment that we talked about earlier. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. It'll help us get the channel out there and get the word out.